was happening.
They didn't even stop them.
Right-wing party spokesman slapped a left-wing politician in the face.
In Germany, raising a Nazi salute would get you arrested. In Greece, it got a party elected. Golden Dawn began life as a violent neo-Nazi street gang and grew into a political party with seats in both the national and European parliaments.
Despite its frightening and sometimes violent presence on the streets, Golden Dawn is now Greece's third largest party.
Greece is only the beginning.
But in October 2020, it all came crashing down.
Half a dozen of its neo-Nazi leaders were taken into custody over the weekend.
This is how Greece's third largest political party went from parliament to prison, and how Golden Dawn's second in command became Europe's runaway Nazi. My name's Tim Hume, and I cover the rise of the far right in Europe. One of the most dramatic illustrations of that rise was in Greece.
Greece is a country that has gone through civil war and periods of dictatorship. I think there was never really a concerted effort to purge the state of right-wing paramilitary elements.
Golden Dawn was founded in the mid-80s by a Holocaust denier who openly admired Hitler.
We may do the Hitler salute, but at least our hands are clean.
Many of Golden Dawn's members had swastikas or other tattoos with Nazi symbols on them. The Nazi salutes were evident in many of their gatherings. It was so evident, their nostalgia of the Third Reich and Germany, it was everywhere.
Despite its frequent street violence against immigrants and left-wing activists, the movement developed into an official, albeit fringe, political party.
The party campaigns with the slogan, "Clear the Filth." The filth, it's code for African and Asian migrants.
Like many far-right groups, it grew by exploiting people who felt forgotten and marginalized.
They take people that are nobodies, completely nobody, and they create from him a monster because they fill him with all these ideas, with all this hate, and this guy feels like he's a hero.
But in the aftermath of the 2008 financial crisis, Golden Dawn saw a golden opportunity.
This much red means bad news. Today, all the graphs were moving in the wrong direction.
Greece lost 25% of her GDP. This is war figures. Greeks felt a big, big humiliation. Then you go to riots, and when you are in the streets, you know that people are really pissed off. People used to say that hunger gives very bad advice.
The war is in front of us. It is an economic war.
By 2012, more than a quarter of the country was unemployed. For young people, the figure surged to more than 50%.
Why do you want the country to get out of the euro?
Because I can't live within the European Union. I can't live. I'm starving, I'm dying.
The European Union gave Greece a financial bailout on the condition that the country impose harsh austerity measures.
Without the money, Greece will go bankrupt next month.
Golden Dawn seized on this to amplify its anti-globalist, anti-EU message.
They also tried to ride that wave of despair that many Greeks felt at the time.
Eventually, this led to actual political power. In 2012, 18 members of the openly fascist party were elected to the Greek parliament.
We should not forget that at the height of their power, about 500,000 people voted for them. But it also seems that xenophobia and racism is deeply rooted in some part of the Greek society.
Once elected, they tried to sell themselves to the public as the good guys, setting up Greek-only food banks and blood donation drives where only Greeks could donate. But Golden Dawn's leaders didn't just become politicians. They developed an almost celebrity status. One MP became known as the rock star of Golden Dawn because he was a member of a black metal band. Another traded on his image as a good-looking tough guy, with the media obsessively covering his workout routines and gossip around his love life, even after he physically assaulted a female MP on live television.
You might expect a party that was trying to gain electoral credibility to tone down its violence and try and look respectable, Golden Dawn went in the opposite direction.
But away from the celebrity gossip columns, the group's unrelenting violence was happening in the streets in broad daylight.
It was planned and orchestrated from the top, and that the people who carried out the violence were not doing it spontaneously, but they were organized into squads of people that were trained to attack other people, and they did it in a very disciplined way.
They were definitely going to be a murder. It was smelling like blood, that they were going to do something bad.
At the height of the European migrant crisis in 2015, hundreds of thousands of people flooded into and through Greece. These migrants made an easy target for Golden Dawn's hateful rhetoric and violent attacks.
Groups like Golden Dawn, extremist groups, need to create an enemy. This is how they can survive. Hatred is their fuel.
Of course, they cannot stay here. We will give them travel papers to go to any country they want to go in Europe.
I was approached by a now convicted Golden Dawn member. He said that they were going to cleanse the squares of Athens, that there would be no immigrants hanging out in these places.
But the mistake that would lead to their downfall was targeting a Greek. On the night of September 17th, 2013, some of Golden Dawn's members received a text telling them to come to a local office. One of the party's critics, the popular left-wing rapper and activist Pavlos Fissis, who recorded under the name Killer P, had been spotted at a cafe in Athens watching a football match with friends. The mob of Golden Dawn members headed there and targeted Pavlos in the street. Georgios Rupakios, who worked in Golden Dawn's offices, stabbed him to death.
He felt like he was doing something for the leader, for the head of the party. He was doing something for the whole Greek race.
A political party openly organizing a brutal assassination on the street was too much, even for Golden Dawn, and thousands of people took to the streets in anger.
The main majority of the people opened their eyes when Pavlos was murdered, because he was white, because he was Greek, and because he was as my son, as my cousin, as my brother. So this changed things. If they can kill him, they can kill us.
Arrest warrants were issued, and there were raids on party offices and members' homes. Golden Dawn began falling apart.
The killer, Georgios Rupakios, who was very surprised to be arrested, when he was in the car of police, he says, "Hey, I'm one of you, what are you doing?"
A lot of people in the police were supporters of Golden Dawn, a lot, even now they are.
There were lots of well-documented incidents where Golden Dawn assault squads, young men dressed in black, carrying weapons or broken bottles, pieces of wood, would attack migrants in the street. And there were lots and lots of reports of how this often seemed to be done in coordination with local police units, that police would either be standing back and looking on as it happened, or even that sometimes there was a sort of tag team operation.
For Greek neo-Nazis, an unusual feeling, dismay. The police force, long criticized for ignoring them, has turned on them.
Killer P's death triggered the biggest trial of Nazis since Nuremberg. The legal battle spanned more than half a decade and involved 68 members of Golden Dawn.
This trial was the most important trial in Europe after World War II.
Golden Dawn was structured along the lines of the original German Nazi Party, where you have a kind of open-facing political party structure that you can sign up as a member for, but you have a closed, hidden structure that works along the lines of a military command, where the members who are inducted into that closed structure are organized into cells. And that's how they were referred to during the trial, closed cells of activists who were indoctrinated in neo-Nazi ideology, but also trained in forms of combat, effectively.
Finally, in October 2020, the Greek courts officially declared Golden Dawn a neo-Nazi criminal organization.
Prime Minister of Greece vowed today to do whatever it takes to eradicate the extreme right Golden Dawn Party.
Its leaders were sentenced to 13 years in jail, close to the maximum 15 years possible under the country's penal code.
Χρυσής Αυγής, Νικόλαος Μιχαλονιάκος, κρίνεται ένοχος για
the most consistent presence was Pavlos Fissas's mother, Magda, who I'm pretty sure she attended, if not every single day of the trial, then almost every one. And she would sometimes challenge the people in court. She gave evidence herself. There was a very tense moment where she threw a bottle of water at some of the Golden Dawn members that she accused of being responsible for the murder of her son.
Against her will, she became a symbol of anti-fascist movement. Absolutely convinced that without Magda Fissa, they wouldn't have been now in prison. I'm sure of that.
Most of Golden Dawn's leadership is now in prison, but their second in command is still on the run. No one knows where Christos Papas is exactly, but intelligence suggests he's crossed the border into Serbia or Kosovo dressed as a monk, having spent some time in a monastery. However, the story back in Greece may not be over just yet. Many activists fear that the economic pressures created by the pandemic could give rise to a new violent right-wing movement to fill the vacuum Golden Dawn left behind.
Greece get rid of Golden Dawn, not of far right, not of racism, not of the ghost of the past. This needs a lot of work and a lot of political will that until now we have not. But it's a turning point, that's for sure.
You had a lot of really brave Greek citizens, migrants, refugees and so on, who were willing to stand up and challenge that head on. The Greek state was willing to stand back and let it happen effectively until in 2013 it was belatedly forced to act. What it shows you is that fascist violence is something that, if it's not confronted head on and is allowed to grow, can really spin out of control and has the potential to take over a society.